Good morning dear students, welcome to Narayana Life Classes. For class 8 students, today we are going to discuss about assessment number 24. In that the first question is, according to Bohr theory, the radius of an electron in an orbit described by principal quantum number n and atomic number z is proportional to. Now here, what is principal quantum number? Principal quantum number is indicated by small n. Okay, now here principal quantum number is indicated by small n, and here if you come to atomic number is indicated by z here. Now here radius of a specific element means from distance, what is radius here? Distance from nucleus to the outermost orbit we are taking as radius here. Okay, now for the calculation of radius of a specific atom or element, here it is directly proportional, according to the Bohr theory, it is directly proportional to z square by n here. It is z square by n here. What is z here? Z is called as atomic number, and here n is called as principal quantum number. Z square. Now here z square is nothing but what? Z into z. Z is atomic number now. Now atomic number and z square by n we can take here. N is principal quantum number. By using that formula, we can calculate the radius of a specific element here. Okay. Now come to the second question. The radius of an orbit in hydrogen atom is equal to, here just now we discussed here, they are asking for radius of the orbit in hydrogen atom, means the hydrogen atom means atomic number is 1 for the hydrogen atom, and number of electrons present in the hydrogen atom also 1 only here, and here for that, for the calculation of that one, we have to use the formula, that is m square h square by 4 pi square m z e square. Now here in this, what is n here? N is called as principal quantum number, and h is called as Planck constant, and m is called as mass of the electron, and z is called as atomic number for the specific element we can take. What is the specific element here? Hydrogen atom is the specific element, and e is the charge of the electron we can take here. Okay, now here in this, what are changing? Principal quantum number n is changing, and atomic number z is changing for different elements here. Okay, the remaining are constants only now. Then this formula you can write as h square by 4 pi square m e square. Now what is the remaining part? It is, I can take as n square by z I can take. N square by z I can take. Okay. Now here n square by z, n is principal quantum number, z is called atomic number. By using this formula, we can calculate the radius of the specific element. Okay? Right? Now come to the next question. Which of the following is the radius of first orbit of hydrogen atom? Now here given options are in terms of what they are given, in terms of angstrom units they are given here. Now here in this for nth orbit I can take as Rn is equal to 0.529 into n square by z I can take for calculating the radius of the nth orbit. Radius of the nth orbit. Now in the given question, for the first orbit they asked. For the first orbit they asked. Now for the first orbit means it on orbit number n, how much they are given? N is equal to 1 they are given. N is equal to 1 they are given. And for first orbit of hydrogen atom they wrote. Now what is the atomic number for hydrogen atom? It is also 1 only. Then if you substitute these two values in this, R1 I am writing. N is equal to 1, orbit number 1, then R1 I can write. R1 is equal to 0.529 into 1 square by 1. Then that is equal to R1 is equal to 0.529 angstrom units. Then the answer what you can take? The first answer we can take. Okay, later we can calculate the radius of the different elements we can calculate. Okay, now go to this another question. The radius of fourth orbit in hydrogen atom, same formula, but your orbit number is changed here, and element also same. Then hydrogen atomic number z is equal to 1 I can take. In the before question also z is equal to 1 only, why? Means element is same, but here what is changed? Your orbit number is changed here. Then once again same formula I am using. Rn is equal to 0.529 into n square by z I can take. Then here n is equal to what they are given orbit number 4, they are given equal to 4, they are given. Then z is equal to 1, they are given. Then here r 4 is equal to 0.529 into 4 square by 1. That is equal to 0.529 into 8. That is R4 in angstrom units it is. Then if you calculate this one, R4 is equal to nearly this is 0.5, no? 0.5 means 0.529 into 4 square, sorry. 4 square means it is 16, no? Into 2. Okay. 16 means if you take nearly 8 point something, you will get the answer. Means by 2, no? Then answer I can take as 8 point something. Then we can take as 8.464 angstrom units I can take. Okay. Then the answer is third one I can take. Right? Now come to the next question, the last question. Which of the following is correct? Which of the following is correct? Now this is also related to Bohr theory only. They are asking about radius formula. Then Rn is equal to 0.59 into n square by z. Same formula here also. Angstrom units. Then if you see all the options, then n square by z, we can go for the first option. Right? Just now we discussed about this formula and we calculated different problems related to it. Okay?